Ammo School is brought to you by Kent Cartridge. Performance, innovation, and excellence.
I know that a bit of a complaint after the changes is that steel just does not have the hitting power that lead did. And I know that bismuth and tungsten and some different steels, there's a lot of different options out there. When a weekend duck hunter, you know, does want to go out and start shooting, fast steel, silver steel, tungsten, bismuth, what's the right direction for somebody to start the research?
Well, certainly it would require research because there are extreme differences between the various products that are available out there, not only in performance, but obviously in price consideration as well. But it's funny that you mentioned the evolution to the utilization of steel as a projectile material. Is that, yeah, a lot of the old school guys, they continuously complained about, oh, you know, lead works so much better. And initially, back in the early days, as I alluded to previously, the velocities weren't available mm-hmm. back then. With the advent of those specialty propellants, velocities of steel loads have increased from back in the old, just after the lead days, from 12 to 1,275 feet a second, which was pretty much a replica of what the lead loads were driven at. Nowadays, we have loads that range anywhere from 1,500 feet a second up to 1,625 feet a second, and some manufacturers are even exceeding that. And with that increase in velocity, it basically created a whole new series of shot shells that were far more effective than the early generation of shot shells. Okay. And today, you will find many of the most experienced shooters out there who will say, I wouldn't go back to lead even if I could. Because there are certain benefits to steel, mostly in penetration, somewhat in patterning, that can make steel a very, very effective waterfowl load. The only real negative of steel versus lead is that at extreme range, those pellets, because they're 25% lighter, do not maintain their energy at distance the same as what lead pellets did. But within that sort of framework, keep in mind that because steel pellets are 25% lighter, you have a 25% denser pattern with the same pellet size. So at the closer distances where steel really does shine, you've got denser patterns, which can in fact be more effective than the old lead patterns simply because of that density.